You're listening to Magic 105.4. This is The Green Room. I'm Joe Parkinson, and I'm now joined in the studio by the man with the bluest eyes in baking. It's Paul Hollywood.
I thought you were going to say Mary Berry then.
Calling Mary Berry a man?
No, she's got blue eyes though.
I know, but I said the man with the bluest eyes. Me. How are you?
I'm good. No, I'm very good.
Good to see you.
Yeah, and you?
I just want to bombard you with Bake Off.
But
let's talk about your book first, because you've got a book out. It's called Paul Hollywood's British Baking.
Yes.
And it kind of does what it says on the tin, really, doesn't it?
Well, it's exactly what it is. What I've done is, it's another recipe book. I've got breads in there. I've got pies. I've got puddings. I've got cakes. But what I've done is section them off into regions. You've got the Southwest, London and the Southeast. You've got the North. You've got Scotland. You've got Wales. You've got Ireland. And I thought it was a great way of doing a book. So you've got little maps to show you the regions that I'm representing. And then I've done bakes from that region. And I think it's recipes that I've liked, recipes that friends have given to me. And I thought, yeah, that works. That'll fit in there nicely. But I've tried to fly the flag a little bit for British baking, because I think we're very good at it in this country. And I think we can hold a candle to anyone in Europe. A good bake in this country will challenge anybody in France.
Yeah. Well, what do they know?
What do they know?
I do love the French attitude, though, is that, you know, a day without bread is like a day you're basically dead, aren't you?
They
have bread every single day.
I think you should. I mean, I lived in Cyprus for 6 years, and again, bread is a focal part of the diet. You know, everything feeds around bread. But the whole point of the bacon, I mean, one of my favourite recipes in there is a Bakewell tart. A Bakewell tart made well is gorgeous.
Yeah.
It's not Bakewell pudding, that's different, that's the original, but this is a Bakewell tart. Is fantastic, and it's the same, and I use fresh raspberries in it as well, so when you get through that almond frangipane you hit this fresh raspberry and then a crispy base. Eccles cakes, beautiful, absolutely stunning. Barra Brith, the Welsh bread, Boxty's or Boxty bread, gorgeous.
Welsh bread.
Barra Brith's delish.
Yeah.
I mean, it's something my nan used to make. She was Welsh, and we used to go to North Wales a lot, and I remember having it in the little tea rooms, you know.
Yeah.
And it was went to those, always, nan always took me to those tea rooms in Wales that they don't speak any English. And I walked in and I said, What are you saying? I don't know whether she made it up. She'd say they're telling stories. And I said, what stories? And then I'd be absorbed in the story for about an hour. I love my nan. She was great.
Oh, that sounds lovely. So the recipes in there all look absolutely amazing. But mm-hmm. from someone who, I try and watch, you know, what I eat a little bit, I'm like, God, it's all very calorific, to be honest, isn't it? Everything that you do, even when I'm watching Bake Off, I'm like, oh my God, that's amazing. What are they putting in there? All that butter. I just wonder how you stay so trim. I always think, God,
I'm not trim.
Berry.
Do you wear glasses?
You're not like.
Are you that? You're
big.
A liar.
You're not massive,
the thing is,
are you?
I'm a fat bloke from the north, right? And the whole thing about it is, I eat exactly what was given to me, especially on Bake Off. And you know, you could get a cake pudding. One of the things is, I remember what was really funny. We had one bake-off, I think, this year. We had the pies. And I think Kate did a 3-tier pork pie with a pear, an apple, and something else. We had to eat a bite of each one, and there was 10 of them. You know, that's ridiculous. And you sit there having mouthful after mouthful after pie. And then at the end, everyone goes, right, let's go for dinner. I said, are you kidding me?
Are you having a laugh?
I said, obviously, I went for dinner.
You went for dinner.
You've got to be really careful how much you eat, especially on Bake Off.
Because Mel and Sue have said in the past that they put on at least a stone during
the
filming.
They say that, but they don't. Sue looks great.
Yeah.
And Mel looks fantastic as well. Mary, she's terrible. When she lets that girdle go at the end of Bake Off, it's ridiculous.
I love the fact that you and Mary have both got books out at the moment, so it's kind of like a book off.
Do you know what? It's a similar... I noticed she's got a similar thing on the
she
front as well.
She copied you?
Yeah, she did. That's plagiarism. I'm going to have you, Berry. The thing is, she's got a... She's using a sieve, an icing sieve, and she's getting, you know, the icing on the front of her. Look at that! I've got flour on the front of mine.
So what have you actually pulled her up on this?
I have done, yeah. Yeah, we're having a bit of an arm wrestle about it.
Are you having
tomorrow.
A book off?
We are, yeah. I tell you what, I can't have an arm wrestle with her. I mean, she's nearly, you know, 180 years old. So what we're going to do is, is have a game of darts.
Okay.
And do it civilly, you know.
She does win in the style stakes, though, I have to say.
She does. She I don't like
brilliant.
Dresses.
Well, no, or Zara bomber jackets, or M&S bomber jackets.
There was one, though, on the programme. She wore, like, a stork.
Yeah, that's the M&S
bomber. Well, I thought that looked... I didn't like that one.
Did you not?
No. Because it looked like a curtain. And when she came out, I said to her, I said, Mary, you can't wear that. Do you like it? I said, no, I didn't like that. That's the only one that I'd never liked.
And now bestseller for Marks & Spencer.
Exactly. What do I know?
I think it's
the
sold
big
out.
Style man myself
That's
I am.
That's right, exactly. What do you know?
I know nothing.
So let's talk Bake Off then. I actually thought I might be a bit scared of you because I think you're getting meaner as the Bake Offs go on. Like you never used to be that mean.
I was.
You were.
I'm not sure mean. I'm honest.
Well, no, you're like you take a bite and they've slaved over it. You go, yeah, it's all right.
Well, it is all right.
I know.
It's not perfect. I think all right's a good word, or good.
It's good.
It's another good word.
It's all right.
It's constructive. So I'll say, you know, if I say it's all right, the reason why it's not good is because you didn't leave it in there long enough. You didn't prove it long enough. You put too much baking powder in there. There's too much salt in there. There's not enough sugar. The colour's pale. The texture's all wrong. So there's a reason behind it. And I always go into that. It doesn't often meet the edit.
I know.
But I always tell them, if you ask any of the bakers in that tent, I don't just say, don't like it. And they'll all back me up and say, actually, yeah, he does say you should have done this, this, and this.
Yeah.
And sometimes in the edit, you can't get that in. But no, I always back it up with constructive criticism.
There was actually a big hoo-ha about the editing this year, wasn't there? With the
I'm not sure about that. You see, what actually happened was
episodes.
Real. That was right.
Yeah.
Bingate?
Yes, Bingate.
It happened as it happened.
Yeah.
It's right. But 40 seconds out of the freezer does not melt an ice cream. And that was his second ice cream because the first one failed.
Yeah.
It's all about timing. And if you get the timing wrong, I'm sorry, but everybody else managed to do it.
I think what everyone was so up in arms about was the fact was that Diane said, well, I don't know whose ice cream it was. It was in my freezer. And everyone
was
like, but why did you take it out?
Well, 40 seconds, whether she'd taken it out or nothing, he still would have been left with the same problem. The fact is, he threw it in the bin. You can't throw stuff like that in the bin. That's like having a tantrum, you know? And because a lot of kids watch Bake Off, we can't be seen to praising someone who's throwing something in the bin.
No,
you know, what example does that set to the kids that watch Bake Off? And so, you know, he did mess up. He admitted himself, you know, he messed up. And the recipe was wrong anyway. If we'd seen a sponge or a meringue or something, he just brought me a bin.
I know.
You can't do that.
It was genius. I have to say, one thing I kind of was going to... I was falling out with you from my sofa was like, can you just please say something nice to Norman? Because
you never said one positive thing to Norman.
And I love Norman.
I said his farthings were beautiful. And I said, they are absolutely gorgeous, mate. It was Mary that wanted him out. But don't tell anybody. I was protecting him.
You called him boring. You said he didn't try.
He was a little bit. I mean, he thought pesto was extravagant. That's ridiculous.
Well,
but the whole thing, when you put it into context, right, against the other bakers, he was struggling.
Mm.
Because the other bakers were really pushing the boundary, coming up with amazing flavours and textures. He was a great baker. Don't get me wrong. You don't get into that tent unless you're a great baker. Believe me, Norman is a great baker. And against, you know, most people on the streets, he'd beat your hands down. But in the Bake Off tent, you're dealing with people who are almost professionals this year.
Yeah.
And they were all exceptional.
Yeah.
And it's hard when someone has to go at the end of the day, you know, and unfortunately it was Norman's.
I think I cried once because I was like, why is everyone being horrible to Norman?
Not being horrible to Norman. That's only
anyway,
in your head.
He's got an autobiography out, so he can't be that boring.
Has he?
Yeah, like at the end of the final, you know, it says on the screen what everybody's doing now. And it's Norman is writing his autobiography.
Good man.
So I was like, well, when's that coming out? It's going to be a bestseller.
It might take a while. It might take a while. Norman's family are bakers, you know, and he knows his stuff. Because when I was talking to him, he knew exactly what he was doing. But I'm sorry, when he brought that lemon tart over to me and you couldn't see the top for icing sugar. Because he had his...
That was the one, I think
he put
I
that
cried.
Ball in a bag. So he had this...
Yeah.
He had this ball in a bag with the icing sugar and he was shaking it and all the icing... And he couldn't see the top. The point of a lemon tart is you can see the top. He never wrote Tartar Citron, or he tried to.
He tried.
I know.
That was the one where I was like, oh, please don't get Norman out. I just felt so...
I felt bad, to be honest.
Yeah.
I did feel bad.
Do you feel bad, though?
No.
Like, because these... No. These people are literally... I mean, especially for the final, like, I was really moved by this year's final.
Yeah.
When, like, Nancy finished, and she just welled up, because they're working so hard, aren't they? And the stress and the pressure.
The final this year was incredible. You could cut it with a knife. I mean, Richard was really feeling it in the final. You know, he knew he'd messed up on the first day, and Louis was fighting for it as well. But Nancy was, like, cool as a cucumber.
I know.
I mean, what a time to start shining,
you
know.
She pulled it out, didn't she?
She did incredibly well. And when we look back, actually, throughout the programme, she was the most consistent out of all of them. You know, don't forget, Richard was nearly went 2 weeks ago.
Yeah.
And she just remained there, just sitting above the top. That's the place to be.
Yeah.
And she won the first... She was star baker in the first programme as well.
Richard was star baker 6 times. That's why I was like, 5 times. Yeah, I was like, how can you not win? And finally, we've had Taylor Swift in recently, who's revealed that she's a very keen baker. Mm-hmm. Are there any other celebrities that you know of who are great bakers that you've met at parties, whatever, they come up to you and chatted about stuff?
I have met a few. Sarah Milligan's a big baker. She loves to bake. Warwick Davis. Warwick Davis is a good baker
really?
As well. Yeah. Johnny Vaughan.
Johnny Vaughan can't bake.
To, but he can't. He was on Celebrity Bake Off
a couple of years ago. Genius. That was so good.
Yeah, mate, it was hilarious.
But he's full on Johnny, isn't he?
It is.
I used to work with Johnny.
Yeah.
Did you? So I know him very well.
It was hilarious. And but there are a couple of people out there that bake and sportsmen that really get into baking. But the strangest, you know, Fern Cotton, she's a big baker as well. Fern loves baking.
Well, I wish I could bake. I just haven't got a big enough kitchen. That's my excuse anyway. Paul Hollywood, thank you so much for coming in to talk to us. And your book, Paul Hollywood's British Baking, is out now.
Thank you.